Saints John and Paul, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Today we celebrate the feast day of the two saints who gave their lives as martyrs during the reign of Julian the Apostate, as he is called. That is to say that when the persecutions were over, and seemingly peace had come after three centuries to the church, and that the Roman Empire was subjected finally to the cross of a Christ, that at that very moment, when so many souls were lulled into a false sense of security, why then the emperor, Julian, was not only baptized, but even admitted to the minor orders of the church, that he apostatized from the faith and did his very best not to conduct an open persecution, but to promote paganism by every indirect means possible. Our two saints today were servants or officials in the court of the daughter of Constantine. And they were known for their probity, for their talent, and for their good name. And Julian very much wanted them to come over and to work for him, because then that would increase his own reputation. He himself was a man of terribly disordered life, probably of some mental problems we would say today. When he was at school, he was at school in Athens with St. Basil the Great and St. Gregory Nazianzen. He was known for his outbursts in class and things like that. And he thought in his foolishness and his pride that he could conquer our Lord. So he wanted these two men to come with him. Now, Dom Guéranger tells us that he didn't insist that they deny our Lord. He simply wanted them to accept the fact that he, the emperor, had apostatized from Christianity and would work now to restore paganism, but they could keep their private beliefs privately. There perhaps would have been, in the name of prudence, some argument that somebody could have made. Well, it would be important for you to be at the side of the emperor because, you see, after all, you could minimize the bad effects of his reign against Christians. And who knows, in time, by your good example and all the rest of it, you might be able to persuade him back again. But these two brothers, Christians, were so disgusted with the apostasy of the emperor and were so imbued with the true spirit of fortitude which the Holy Ghost gives us at confirmation that they absolutely refused to do anything to justify the reign of this truly a wretch who had turned his back on Almighty God and the Son of God for the worship of demons. Because of that, then, the emperor grew angry, and he told them that unless they were willing to worship the idol, why then, that their lives would be forfeit. They were given a number of days to think about it, and during that time, they distributed all of their goods to the poor, and then the Roman officer Terentius came to their home privately, carrying an idol, a traveling idol, which he set up then in the atrium of the house, and they were simply to worship this idol once, and all would be well. And of course, they refused to. And because of that, they were beheaded, and then they were buried in their own homes. And all of this was done privately, because it was sort of a private persecution that he was waging, as he would not deliberately dare to take on the whole Catholic Church, but privately, a little bit at a time, Julian the Apostate was. But all of his efforts were in vain. Our two saints went to heaven. Their home was made into a church, which today is one of the most beautiful basilicas in Rome, the Basilica of Saints John and Paul. And Julian the Apostate died only a year later, but he died exactly 1 year later after the martyrdom of these two saints. That was our Lord's judgment and vindication of them. And remember that the apostate's last words were, "Thou hast conquered Galilee," as indeed our Lord has, as we say in the prayer, "Christ reigns, Christ rules, Christ conquer." And that is our profound belief, of course, as Catholics. Whenever we're tempted to go along to get along, it is good to read the lives of the martyrs and to pray for a little bit of their spirit to Our Lady, the Queen of Martyrs. Let us ask her for her assistance today. The Church of Saints John and Paul in Rome was given just around the time of the French Revolution to the Passionist Fathers. The Pope did that as a way of honoring not only St. Paul of the Cross, but also his brother, who was a kind of a co-founder of the Passionists, whose name was John. And by that means, he made a memorial of these two brothers and of their wonderful work that lasted for several centuries of promoting the devotion to the Passion of our Lord. We have to pray for the Passionist order today, as well as for the whole of the social order, and for the restoration of Christ and his rights as our King. Now, just before Holy Mass, we'll say a prayer to these saints, and then the daily devotion to the Sacred Heart. These are the two olive trees and the two candlesticks giving light before the Lord. They have power to close heaven that the clouds rain not, and to open the gates thereof, for their tongues are made keys of heaven. Pray for us, St. John and Paul, martyrs, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. O God, infinitely holy, if my sins provoke thee and make me hateful in thy sight, look upon the Lamb without spot that taketh away the sins of the world. Behold the Sacred Heart of thy divine Son. This heart, infinitely merciful, prayed for me on Calvary and will now renew the sacrifice of itself for me upon the altar. Eternal Father, I offer thee the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, thy beloved Son, in satisfaction for my sins and for the wants of the Holy Catholic Church. Remember, O good and gentle Jesus, that none who had recourse to thy Sacred Heart implored its assistance or cried for pardon were ever abandoned. Animated with this confidence in thy goodness and mercy, O divine heart, and groaning beneath the weight of my own iniquities, I prostrate myself before thee. Have pity on me and hear my prayer. Our Father in heaven, who has deigned to give thee to us for our salvation, will, through thee and united with thee, receive our prayers this day. To thy merit, we hope to obtain the pardon of our sins, the special graces we ask for in this Mass, and above all, the grace of perseverance, that with the angels and the saints we may praise thee now on earth and bless thee forever in heaven. O sweetest heart of Jesus, I implore that I may ever love thee more and more. May the divine assistance remain always with us. May the souls of the faithful departed, to the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.